This Peter Parker is not the same guy from the beginning of this movie.
The Spider-Man that believes in second chances and believes anyone can change isn't here right now.
Because the man standing across from him that he tried to save and give a second chance
murdered the woman that raised him.
This Peter Parker has absolutely no interest in trying to see the good in this guy anymore. This Peter wants to kill Norman Osborn.
Which is exactly what the Goblin wants.
He wants to turn Spider-Man to the dark side.
Well, his wish has partially come true.
Because this guy right here is on demon time. The Green Goblin.
Arguably the best Spider-Man villain of all times.
And not only that, but the same exact iteration of this character from the first Spider-Man movie in 2002. Epic! Everyone knows, in 2002, Willem Dafoe killed this role. But we might as well just call him Willem DeGoat at this point, because this man came back 20 years later like he never left at 67 years old!
Sorry. Not really sure what just happened to my voice there, but that's beside the point. Earlier in this movie, in the condo, this guy gave Peter the worst beating he's ever received.
Which brings me to one of the first things I said in this video. This is not the same Peter.
This one's filled with rage, anger, he wants revenge.
And most importantly, he wants to avenge Aunt May.
So all I can really say at this point is good luck. Ooh, rough start.
Probably should have kept those goggles on.
Poor Peter. Too weak. To send me home to die.
Taunting in classic Gobby fashion.
No. I just want to kill you myself.
Attaboy.
See how happy he got? He's like a proud father. And Pete is not having it. He's heard just about enough of this guy's yapping.
Like I said, it's demon time.
Sheesh, you lucked out there, Greeny.
If he connected with that,
it already would have been lights out.
What? No way.
Gob's got the spider slicer pickaxe and the wild whistle emote?
What a sweat.
Mm-hmm. Yep. He stole his parents' credit card for sure.
Watched this movie about 30 times now, and I'm just now realizing for the first time that he's trying to web his whole leg here.
Yeah, pretty cool.
I don't know how I missed it every single time I watched it.
You know what? Actually, I do. It happens in like 0.3 seconds.
My fault. Sorry, Marvel. I should have known not to blink.
Nope.
Alright, now I'm pissed.
If you couldn't tell from the look on my face,
you sliced my arm.
And I'd do the same to you if I was a bitch.
But I'm not.
So instead, I'm gonna punch you in the nose, half as hard as I actually can.
Yeah. Whew. That one felt good.
Speaking of good, I have a very good feeling that I'm gonna be doing a lot of dicks through the rest of this video, and I'm honestly ecstatic about it.
It's fun, I have fun.
Miss. See ya.
See that?
Holy shit!
Get fucked, Gobby!
Different breed.
This one absolutely deserves
an instant replay. Easily my favorite choreographed Spider-Man move ever.
It is so gratifying to finally see Tom Holland Spider-Man throwing hands.
I could shed a tear.
But I'm not gonna.
Because just like Tom, I ain't no bitch.
Get your ass up.
Stay down, what's
that?
What?
The head nod?
Yes, the head nod.
Oh, I don't know. I just thought we were on the same.
No,
same.
We
page.
Weren't.
Look, all I know is this is looking far worse than I originally thought.
Yeah,
right. And that's what I'm saying.
Okay.
Yeah. No. I've messed some people up pretty bad in my days, but I have never gone rated R.
Exactly.
Precisely.
I thought it was always like a known thing that we're kid friendly.
Right.
It's this new generation, these young kids, you know?
Tell me about it. Now, being the OG and all, I expect a little more respect.
No, for sure.
And, you know, there's mutual respect between me and you.
Of course.
Your movies were peak.
Thank you. They were. Thank you.
Yeah, yours were very underappreciated. I myself personally enjoyed them a lot.
And I still think they need to give you a third movie.
I've been saying.
Yeah, we need
I've been saying.
This is great. I needed this.
Reminiscing with a fellow Spidey.
Me too.
But, we should probably come up with a plan to save Lil Bro from going down a dark path.
Dark path. The dark path, right?
Damn! Let's go, Tom!
Everyone was
was hating on you. They said you couldn't hang with the goblins. They said you're the weakest Spider-Man, and you can't throw hands like your elders.
Look at you now. Look how far you've come.
From one Spidey to another, I am proud of you.
And you can bet your ass that Tony and Aunt May are up in MCU heaven just as proud as I am.
Wait, what's he... What's he doing? Tom, what are you thinking here? No, Tom. It's not worth it. He's not worth it, Tom!
No!
Oh, thank God. Thank God for you, Toby.
He was about to impale him with his own glider. Just like you did in the first well, you didn't necessarily impale him yourself, but... I mean, technically you did kill him. But nonetheless, you just saved a fellow younger Spider-Man from going down a dark path.
And no words even had to be spoken. That's how you know you're joking.
This was just... such a beautiful moment,
seeing the Spider-Man I grew up watching,
saving the Spider-Man of the present and the future from himself.
It doesn't get much better than this.
No Way Home has its flaws, just like any other movie.
But to me, overall, this was an amazing film.
And an almost perfect Spider-Man movie. You know, for an old guy, Toby's still strong as fuck. It's crazy that in the first Spider-Man movie, Norman died before Peter even got a chance to help him. But here, in a different universe, he has a chance to save him, and he does.
That's what Spider-Man does.
Maybe after this, he can really help him change. And they could even become pals.
Ah. This slimy green fuck.
She was there. Because of you.
Give me a break. This guy's still going?
I may have struck the blow, but you...
One of my biggest critiques about this movie. Pete literally just beat Gobby to a pulp. And not even one drop of blood? I mean, come on. It would have made the beatdown feel a lot more impactful. Just that little detail would have made such a big difference. But they did bring Toby and Andrew back, so I guess I'll let it slide.
You are the one that killed her.
It's like you don't remember what I just did to you. If it wasn't for the Spider-Man from your universe that already ended you, stopping me, you'd be coughing up that green steroid serum that you took, taking your final breaths. So if you know what's best for you, shut the f*** up. All right, hands up. You did it. I'm proud of you, kid. And as for the goblin,
see you, chump.
Yay, we did it. Now I get to go back to my universe, where I have nothing and no one. Fuck.
Peter.
Yay, the cure worked. Everyone's happy and safe. Except for
Pete.
My dead aunt.
Peter,
you
no,
stupid
Pete,
bitch.
Stop.
Let me at
He's
him.
He's cured.
Let me
He's
at him. It. It's
no
over.
Dark, no dark path.
What's going on, man? It's been a minute.
Wait, how? I don't... What the fuck? You gave me superpowers. Superhero, now you gave me superpowers.